This kit comes with carbon polyolefin, conductive textile, conductive thread, gaff tape, and fusible fabric. You will also need a ruler, a pencil or pen, tape, scissors, an iron, and a piece of cloth. Notice that one of the fusible fabric sides is shiny. Place this fabric in a portrait position with the shiny side down. Now mark a half an inch off from the bottom edge. Continue to make marks every half an inch until the other bottom edge, so that you have 5 segments separated by 4 marks. Repeat the same process towards the top edge. Take a ruler and draw a line from each one of the top marks to the corresponding bottom mark to create a straight line. Now count 3 lines and cut the fabric in 2 so that there is a section with 3 segments and one with 2. At this point, you should plug in your iron on the medium to high setting so that it has time to heat up. With the shiny side up, fold the 3-segment piece of fusible fabric so that the first segment folds over the second, and then those 2 segments fold over the third. This ensures that all of the adhesive is on the inside of the fabric. You should not be able to see any of the shiny side anymore. With the fabric folded, use the piece of cloth to cover the fabric in order to protect it from burning while you iron the cloth and, in effect, the fabric underneath it. You should only have to iron for a couple of seconds for the adhesive to activate. The adhesive will melt and the fabric should now stick together so that it appears as one thicker segment. Take the 2 pieces of conductive textile, which appear golden on one side and white on the other, and place them golden side up on the piece of fusible fabric that you just folded. Ensure that the textiles line up with the fabric on each edge with a space between the textiles. These 2 textiles should not be touching. Once again, cover the fabric and textiles with a piece of cloth and iron over it for a few seconds until the textiles are attached to the fabric. This combination will serve as the sensor's base. For now, place the base to the side. Now take the 2-segment piece of fusible fabric which we cut off earlier and cut it in half to separate the 2 segments into single segments. One of the segments can be put off to the side. It is an extra piece provided to you in case you make a mistake during this step. Place the remaining segment of fabric in a landscape position and mark it from one edge at each of these measurement points, 1/2 inch, 1 inch, and 1 3/4 inch. Cut the fabric segment at each of these marks. You should now have just over 2 inches left. We will be using this leftover piece later on. We will only need the first 3 cuts for now. Take the base of the sensor, which is the fabric with the 2 textiles attached, and place one of the 2 half-inch pieces of fusible fabric shiny side down onto one edge of this piece. On the opposite side of the base from where you had placed your piece of fusible fabric, make a mark after 1/2 inch. The start of this mark is where you will place the other 1/2 inch piece of fusible fabric. Make sure it is shiny side down. Cover the base with fusible fabric on top with a piece of cloth and once again iron it to activate the adhesive of the 2 pieces of fabric. After a few seconds, depending on your iron type and setting, check to make sure that the 2 pieces of fabric are attached to the base. Sometimes you may need to iron again to ensure that the fabric is fully attached to the base. The center of the base between the 2 pieces of fabric that were just attached should be 1 3/4 inch. Use a ruler to measure and then mark this spot with a pencil or pen. Now take the 3/4 inch piece of fusible fabric that we cut earlier and fold it in half to create a crease that will mark the piece's center. Now unfold the piece and use the crease created by the folding to line up the center of the piece with the mark created in the previous step. Cover the base and the fabric pieces with a cloth and iron it for a few seconds. Make sure that the fabric is attached to the base. Now we need to take the 2 1/4 inch piece of fusible fabric that was left over from earlier and cut off 1/2 inch from the end. We won't be using this 1/2 inch piece. Now take the remaining 1 3/4 inch piece of fabric and fold it in half to create a crease in the center. Cut the fabric in two at the crease so that you now have 2 0.875 inch pieces of fabric. Alternatively, you can follow the method shown in this video. Take one of the 0.875-inch pieces and fold it in half. Holding the piece by the side that has the fold, cut a small triangle towards the center of the bottom edge. Holding the piece by the side that opens, where the triangle was cut, cut the two corners on the folded side of the fabric. There is no precise size requirement for the cut, but try to cut just about the same size as we did in the video. You should have an arrow shape left over. When opened, the fabric should look similar to an X. Complete the same steps on the other 0.875-inch piece of fusible fabric. Now take the two X's and place them shiny side down in the two areas on the base that are blank, ignoring the area that is close to the edge. Cover the base and X's with the cloth and iron it to activate the adhesive on the X's. Check to make sure that the X's are attached to the base. This is how it should look. Cut two pieces of tape, about 1/4 inch each. You can use the edge of the table or your hand to hold the pieces of tape while you are working. Next, take the carbon polyolefin and place it on top of the base, starting from the edge that has the fusible fabric, not the edge that has only the golden conductive textile. If the carbon polyolefin runs over the last piece of fusible fabric that is attached to the base, you may need to cut off a bit, usually 1/4 inch or less, so that you can see just a little bit of the fabric. You should now see the carbon polyolefin, then a piece of the white fusible fabric, and finally the two ends of the conductive textile. Take the conductive thread and place it in the center of the base, going from one edge to the other, starting from 1/4 inch above the fusible fabric. It's okay if the thread runs longer than the bottom edge of the base, but make sure that the beginning of the thread is between the two golden conductive textiles. You want the thread to be as centered as possible. Use the two pieces of tape to hold the thread down to the base. This is temporary. This is how it should look. To prepare the gaff tape, lay it down in front of you, black side down, in landscape position. Now mark 1 inch on each edge, left and right, and use a ruler to draw a straight line between the marks. Cut the tape in two, following the line. Take one of the halves, peel off the back, and place it black side down. Place the base with the thread facing up in the center of the tape, allowing it to stick. You may have to firmly press it down to ensure that the base is attached to the tape. Take the other half of the tape and mark 1/2 inch from the left edge of the tape if it is in a landscape position in front of you. Cut the tape at the mark. Peel off the backing and apply the tape, ensuring that you match the edge of the tape to the edge of the fusible fabric where the golden conductive textile is no longer visible. Use your thumb to slide across the tape to press it down against the base and the tape on the other side. Now use your fingernail or a coin to outline the base on the inside. Cut off any excess tape around the golden conductive textile and the sensor's edges. To remove the thread tail that is sticking out of the bottom end of the sensor, cut off about 1/8 of an inch of the sensor from the end. Now peel off the tape from the top part of the sensor with the thread attached and cut this off. The outlet flexion is now complete. You can now optionally test the sensor using a multimeter. It doesn't matter which wire, red or black, is on each of the golden conductive textile contacts. As you bend the sensor, the resistance changes. After some use, the sensor may not be as accurate as when you first made it. To fix this, Owl developed a technique that will reset the sensor to original working condition. All you need is a tongue depressor. Just lift up a piece of the gaff tape near the golden contacts and slide the tongue depressor inside the sensor until it hits the bottom of the sensor. Then slide it back out. Gently run your thumb over the sensor to close the gap created by the tongue depressor. Your sensor should now be back to original working condition. Thank you for watching the Owlet Flexion tutorial video.